In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that celebrating the mysteries of the Lord's resurrection, we may merit to receive the joy of our redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Those who had been scattered by the persecution that arose because of Stephen went as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, preaching the word to no one but Jews. There were some Cypriots and Cyrenians among them, however, who came to Antioch and began to speak to the Greeks as well, proclaiming the Lord Jesus. The hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number who believed turned to the Lord. The news about them reached the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to go to Antioch. When he arrived and saw the grace of God, he rejoiced and encouraged them all to remain faithful to the Lord in firmness of heart. For he was a good man, filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. And a large number of people was added to the Lord. Then he went to Tarsus to look for Saul. And when he found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year, they met with the church and taught a large number of people. And it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
His foundation upon the holy mountains the Lord loves. The gates of Zion more than any dwelling of Jacob. Glorious things are said of you, O city of God.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
I tell of Egypt and Babylon, among those who know the Lord, of Philistia, Tyre, Ethiopia. This man was born there, and of Zion they shall say, one and all were born in her, and he who has established her is the Most High Lord.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
They shall note when the peoples are enrolled, this man was born there, and all shall sing in their festive dance, my home is within you.
All you nations, praise the Lord. Please stand.
My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them, and they follow me.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The feast of the dedication was taking place in Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus walked about in the temple area on the portico of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, how long are you going to keep us in suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly. Jesus answered them, I told you, and you do not believe. The works I do in my Father's name testify to me, but you do not believe, because you are not among my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all, and no one can take them out of my Father's hand. The Father and I are one. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Mula po noong pagkabata ko sa seminaryo at hanggang ngayon, isa po sa mga naging libangan ko po at namin ay ang maglaro ng basketball. Staple po yan sa bawat seminaryo. And I would say, every basketball player, I suppose, would share this basic principle in every game. At sa mga marahil nanonood at naririto na naglalaro ng basketball, na kapag nasa team ang possession ng bola, we have to defend it so that we have a good offense for it. Hindi pa iikutin ng matagal ang bola, pero gagawa lang ng sapat na paraan para makapuntos at magkaroon ng magandang basket ang kupunan na ito. Once possessed, aalagaan ang bola at dadalhin sa tamang dahilan, hindi ipapanakaw, hindi ito turnover, hindi sana dadalhin sa kabilang kupunan naman ang bolang ito. Aalagaan kapag nasa kamay ang bolang ito. And with that, I would like us to see ourselves, you and me, in the same manner. Hawak tayo ng Diyos at nasa kamay tayo ng Diyos. And we continue to meditate the 10th chapter of St. John as we are still within the fourth week of Easter, which we all celebrated last Sunday, the Good Shepherd Sunday. Nasa puso po ng mabuting pastol na hindi tayo maagaw ng sino man. Twice in today's gospel, the Lord said, "No one can take them out of my hand." Maganda po na gumagawa tayo ng dahilan, ng mga pamamaraan para tayo din ay hindi mawalay o makawala sa kamay ng Diyos. But let us remember, sa una pa lamang, Diyos ang humahawak sa atin, Diyos ang nag-aalaga sa atin, Diyos ang lumalaban para sa atin. The Good Shepherd will do all his best to protect and claim us his own. At hindi lamang po tayo hinahawakan o inaalagaan ng Diyos plainly. But at all times that we cannot be taken out of the Lord's hands, we are just simply led to what is best for us. Nasa palad tayo ng Diyos, kaya naririto po tayo ngayon. We are under the palm and the hands of the Lord, and that is why we are blessed. Nagpupursigi, nagsisikap at naghihilom po tayo dahil nasa mga kamay tayo ng Diyos. Hindi tayo pinapaagaw ng Diyos dahil hawak niya ang bawat isa sa atin. And my dear brothers and sisters, like every ball possession in every game, ginagawa ng Diyos ang lahat para hindi tayo maagaw ng sino man. When we are under God's hands, marahil medyo masakit na tayo ay nagkakaroon ng ilang mga painful moments. But let us feel those moments as His way of defending us from whatever may snatch us away. When we are under God's hands, God is in control. When He is holding us, He is just protecting us. But more than that, God is holding us so that He can lead each and every one of us to our purpose. And He can lead each and every one of us to the blessings He wishes us to receive.
Please stand.
God gives eternal life to the sheep of His flock. Let us pray to the Father, confident that we can never be taken away from His care. For every petition we shall say, "Lord, hear our prayer."
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Pope and the bishops may become true shepherds by leading their flock to good pastures, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who wandered away from the path of righteousness may be led back to the fold, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the youth may hear the voice of the Good Shepherd, calling them to serve God's family in a special way, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may experience the tenderness of the Good Shepherd through the loving care of their families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ, the Good Shepherd, may lead the dead safely home, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and for all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. For all of these we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayers. Bless each one of us in the way you know best. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim:
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.